Today we are talking about moment of inertia part 3 for the subject FMD means fundamental of machine design. Subject code is 3141907 and this is a new syllabus for the GTU. So welcome to my YouTube channel Mechanical Engineering Management. Like, share and subscribe. So let's take one question. State and prove theorem of perpendicular axis applied to moment of inertia. The weightage of this question for examination is 3 marks. This is very important question for the examination. So first of all, this statement of the perpendicular axis theorem. So if Ixx and Iyy be the moments of inertia of a plane section about two perpendicular axes meeting at point O, then the moment of inertia Izz about the axis Zz perpendicular to the plane and passing through the intersection of xx and yy is given by Izz is equal to Ixx plus Iyy. So sometimes this Izz is known as the polar moment of inertia. So it is really a little bit difficult to remember the statement of the perpendicular axis theorem. But you can remember this definition with the help of the explanation. So try to understand the explanation and at the end of this explanation you can remember this statement. So consider a small lamina of area dA having coordinates x and y along OX and OY as shown in figure. So say for example this is the OX, that means the XX axis, and this is OY means YY axis, and this is the intersection of XX axis and YY axis is O means origin point. So here try to understand this OX and OY are both perpendicular to each other, that means this angle is 90 degree in reality. And now consider this very small elemental lamina having area dA. dA means very small area and having coordinates x and y. So I can mention over here this distance is x, means the CG of the lamina from the yy axis, and this distance is y, means the distance from the CG of the lamina from xx axis. So you can say this x and y, these are actually the coordinates along OX and OY. And this plane contain both the OX and OY axis, means this plane is the 2D plane which contains XX axis and YY axis. So now try to understand this definition. IXX and IYY be the moment of inertia of this plane lamina about XX axis and YY axis, and this both are actually perpendicular axis. So you can see OX and OY are perpendicular to each other and meeting at point O. Now if I want to find the moment of inertia Izz about the axis Zz that is perpendicular to this plane. So yellow color is the plane that contains OX and OY, and perpendicular to it and passing through the intersection of this XX and YY axis, that means passing through the point O. So say for example this is the ZZ axis perpendicular to XX axis and YY axis both. And if I want to find moment of inertia about the ZZ axis of this lamina, then you can say Izz is equal to Ixx plus Iyy. So now I think you can understand this statement. So I hope now you can remember this statement of perpendicular axis theorem. Now let's say R is the distance of this lamina from the ZZ axis. So here this distance is XX, so here I can mention this distance is also X. And keep in mind that this angle is 90 degree, means OX and OY perpendicular to each other. And so that with the help of this geometry you can say X square plus Y square is equal to R square according to the Pythagoras law. So from the figure you can say R square is equal to x square plus y square. So you can give the number for this equation as 1. Now moment of inertia of the lamina about xx axis, about xx axis. So you know that moment of inertia is equal to area into distance square. So area is dA and the distance from the xx axis is y. So it is dA into y square. Similarly, you can say moment of inertia of the lamina about yy axis. So that is area into distance square. So IYY is equal to DA into X square. Similarly, moment of inertia of the lamina about ZZ axis. So that is equal to area and distance square, means R square. So IZZ is equal to DA into R square. Now put the value over here of R square from the equation number 1. So I can say IZZ lamina is equal to DA as it is. But now put the value of R square as X square plus Y square. Now open this bracket. So you can say DA into X square plus DA into Y square. And as you know that DA into X square, that is what? IYY. So I can say IZZ lamina is equal to IYY. And what is DA into Y square? So here you can say DA into Y square means IXX. So plus as it is, and instead of that I can say it is IXX. And this equation is known as perpendicular axis theorem. So that you have to remember in the examination, that IZZ is equal to IXX plus IYY, and that is sometimes known as polar moment of inertia. So I think now you can remember this statement of the perpendicular axis theorem with reference to this figure. So thanks my dear friends.